In this video, we're going to look to see how we can perform a McNemar test. So a McNemar test is used when you have nominal data, so you have frequency counts, they fall into a yes or a no category, but you don't have a lot else, you don't have any continuous data. And very importantly, this test is used for paired data. So the study that we have here is we have taken 25 people who are smokers and 25 people who are not smokers. We have then given them a treatment, and then we've looked to see after the treatment how many people are smokers and non-smokers after the treatment. The first thing that you might find useful to do is to look at some of your descriptive statistics. So we can do that by going to Analyze, Descriptive Statistics, and going to Frequencies. So I already had these over here, but just to move them over, you simply select them and press the arrow. There are some options if you want to get extra statistics, but we don't really need those right now. So if I press OK, what we can see here is that we have 25 people in the before group who are non-smokers and 25 people in the before group who are smokers. So 50% of our participants fall into non-smoker or smoker groups. After the treatment, we can see that now we have 72% of our participants are non-smokers and 28% of our participants are smokers. So let's do a McNemar test now to look for a significant difference. So to do this, particularly in SPSS version 27, you go to Non-Parametric Tests, Legacy Dialogues, and then you want the two related samples. So again, I'm just going to reset this. So this is how it normally looks when you first open this test. Wilcoxon will already be selected, so you want to deselect that, and you want to select the McNemar test. You then want to move over your variables into these boxes. And that's all we need to do for the time being, and then we press OK. This shows us that of our non-smokers, people who were non-smokers before the study started, 20 of them were still non-smokers afterwards, but 5 of them became smokers. In the smoking group, we can see that after the study, we only had 9 of them who remained smokers, and 16 of them actually became non-smokers. And if we look further down here into our McNemar table, we can see that this is significantly different. This is less than 0.05. So this would allow us to reject our null hypothesis that the treatment has no effect on smoking. We can say that it does appear as if the treatment does have a significant effect on smoking status.